Hi everyone, it's Mary, the host of 90 Day Oy Vey, where there are lots of kibitz and yentas, that means gossip and nosy bodies. So here we go, guys. So we got introduced to Patrick and Thais, and Patrick held the question and answer session in his Instagram stories. So we all want to know about John. Hey, John, I hit you up in your DM. Get back to me. Everyone wants to know your story. We all love you, John. We love the accent. So everyone wants to know how old John is, whether John is single. He dropped John's Instagram handle in his story. So go follow John, guys. So Patrick answered a couple of more questions. He actually owns the home that he lives in, and he sells smart home and solar door-to-door sales, apparently. And he has connected with his father in Brazil. As you can see, he says his father moved back there after living in the U.S. for 35 years and is retired. And the best part out of this question and answer session, guys, we got introduced to Teodoro, and Teodoro has his own Instagram. So guys, go follow Teodoro. Teodoro is single-handedly one of the best cast members to come out of this season. Teodoro and Theron. Theron is the best human cast member of this season of 90 Day Fiancé, and Theodoro is the best pet of this season of 90 Day Fiancé so far. So go follow Theodoro. That's all I have to say. And we would love to interview Theodoro if possible. So moving on to cute kids in the 90 Day universe. Anna hanging out with her little baby, Gokan. And speaking of Theron, Theron hanging out with a cute doggy. And as his mom put in her story, one of the most compassionate persons and quite the leader in his class. I'm sure he is. Theron has the heart of gold and a smile that can light up a room and melt your heart. So moving on to more cute kids in the 90 Day universe, Liz, Big Ed's fiance, and her daughter both celebrated birthdays. She's 9, Riley, and Liz is 30. So happy birthday to both of them. And happy birthday to Veronica's adorable nephew, Gabriel. He turned 8. So speaking of babies in the 90 Day universe, Jimena tried to play a trick on us, guys. So today, Jimena posted this to her story. As you can see, it's an ultrasound. And she put 5 months. So you would think, oh my goodness, Jimena is 5 months pregnant. But mommy says bad words too. If you don't follow her on Instagram, you should. So she did a little Nancy Drew detective work, which some of us like to do in our spare time. So don't try to fool us. So mommy did something called a reverse Google image search. And basically, this is a stock image, guys. So Jimena went on Google and she searched ultrasound, baby ultrasound picture. And she posted that to make us think that she was 5 months pregnant, when it's bullshit, guys, because as you can see here in the last post, you can find it on Google stock image search. It's a baby ultrasound stock image picture. You can't fool us, Jimena. So speaking of not being able to fool us podcasters, bloggers, if you guys do not follow Mary Pants on Instagram, you should follow her as well, because she's another great Nancy Drew. So Aladdin, Remember him, Aladdin, that was married to Laura? Well, Aladdin got married again, and he posted this on his Instagram, and he put a little heart over his bride's face. Well, you should wipe all of your social media of pictures of your bride, your fiance, because then bloggers like Mary Pants will find her picture. And here we go. So this is Aladdin's new wife. And as you can see from her caption, when you wipe out your pictures from your social media, but you forget your old Twitter and LinkedIn. So if you're going to try to fool us, guys, make sure you wipe all of your social media. Follow Mary Pants as well, guys. So happy birthday wishes to David, who turns 53, and to Eve, who turns 48. And I think they both look damn good for their age. Happy birthday to Shida's mom. And speaking of Shida, she wants to eat in peace. Guys, go follow George. He's on Twitter and Instagram. That's his handle right there. Follow him as well. She wants to eat in peace, guys. I don't know. That's all I have to say. Let's Shida eat in peace. So moving along, Bini. There has been some rumors on the interwebs about Benny's first son, his older son, that basically he abandoned him. And this whole storyline about Bini, you know, so sad about his first son and being so traumatized about what happened with that first relationship is basically bullshit. And that Bini has basically abandoned his son. So he goes to his Instagram story to clear up the rumors about it, as you can see. And he just says that his son has never been legally adopted by anyone in the U.S. because there has been rumors that his ex-wife's new husband has legally adopted his son. And he is saying that is not true. And, you know, he's just saying that out of respect, that he doesn't want people to keep continuing spreading misinformation. So like I always say, there's three sides to every story: his side, her side, and the truth. So, and unfortunately, there is a child that is collateral damage within this story. And then Bini posts a picture, good times. So I just hope whatever the story is, Bini is able to see his son, pay child support, have a relationship, and, you know, his son is able to have a relationship with his father. Emily, she has a message for her haters. Very classy. And Pedro has a message as well. Pedro and Chantel. Their new season is coming up next month. Let's see what happens with that. But Pedro has a message too. Comparing Emily's message and Pedro's message, I think Pedro's a little classier with his message. Emily, girl, you need to grow a little thicker skin. The season just begun. So we have Mariana from 90 Day Caribbean Life looking very pensive over a cup of coffee. May is one of her favorite months. And Cara and her balloons looking very happy over a cup of coffee because she has 10,000 followers. So congratulations, Cara, and your balloons and your 10,000 followers. It wouldn't be a 90-day Oy Vey without Memphis and Hamza. And I do have to give it to Memphis. She has been very quiet on social media. So Memphis has stepped back, and she is taking care of her baby, and she has stepped back from the keyboard. Unlike Hamza, who keeps posting selfies and stories like this. Hamza, a lot of people in the U.S. do not have dental insurance. I did not have dental insurance for a very long time. I want to say until I was in my mid-30s when my husband finally got a good job that I was able to be put on his dental insurance, and I'm very grateful for that. There are many, many people that work long hours and they do not have dental insurance, Hamza. So, you know, life sucks, dude. Okay, sorry about that. He posed how much it costs for him to get all the dental work that he needs done. I mean, I feel bad for the guy, but honestly, what does he want us to do? And it seems like every week he is on Instagram talking about, and I don't want to be mean, but it's like, woe is me, Hamza. And at first it was Memphis spiraling out of control, but Memphis has stepped away from the computer, and I really haven't seen or heard anything from her. So to me, it just seems like she is taking a break, which I have recommended over and over that I personally think that Memphis needed to take a break. So I'm going to say the same to you, Hamza. I think it's time for you to take a break. You can get a cameo from Muhammad if you want. Muhammad is apparently one of the many 1,010 billion 90-dayers that are signing up for cameos. So if you want a cameo from Muhammad and his annoying helium-sounding voice, I'm sorry, guys, go on over to Cameo and get one. And this is another reason why I love Mary Pants. Her memes make me crack up all the time. I mean, I'm going to have to start wearing an adult diaper, her and her memes. So we have Tim, and then we have Tiny Tim, Muhammad. If you don't follow Mary Pants, you need to follow her. We have a throwback to young Caleb, and we have Elijah hanging out in the streets of St. Petersburg. Okay, guys, jibberish, whatever the heck his name is. So he has this thing here, text me for daily motivation. So Jibri thinks that he could give us daily motivation. So I decided to text him and see what kind of daily motivation he can give me. So here we go. We got the automated reply, stop to cancel. Then, you know, you click on the thing, you get this cute little picture of him in his cowboy hat, you know, leaning back. So I text him, hello, Jibri, I need inspiration. 686 days until I turn 50. I need your inspiration, Jibri. I have none. So I wait almost an hour. No response. I mean, Jibri, you put this out there that you're this inspirational line. No response. Not even an automated response, people. I mean, come on. So then almost an hour later, I text Jibri. It's been almost an hour and you leave me hanging here with no inspiration. Not cool, dude. Then you see the response. Now, guys, I just wanted to let you know that when I first, you know, signed up for this, I gave them my name, my phone number, my email address, and my city and my state. So I have a feeling that this is a lead generation type thing where I am going to be bombarded by bullshit emails and bullshit phone calls for the next couple of months. So then I get this. I hope you can have empathy and understand. Thank you for your patience. Then I text again this afternoon. Still uninspired, Jibri. Do you have any words of inspiration for me? And I would say it's been approximately 3 hours since I sent that text. And Jibri, you are leaving me uninspired. Paging Jibri. I'm still waiting for my words of inspiration, dude. You got my number. Hit me up. So we have Molly's Kelly retiring from the NYPD. One last time in uniform. You go, Kelly. I give you kudos. So in Brownsville, one last time in uniform. And we have Rebecca and Zied. And I'm not going to say anything about her mahogany type filters, but Rebecca and Ziad. We have Jasmine in front of a rainbow fountain looking gorgeous as always. We have Libby's dad, Chuck, and Ben in front of a sunset. And I'm going to be nice and just say it's a very nice sunset. Evelyn's brother opened up an ice cream shop. So they sell pizza there. So if you happen to be in their town in Ecuador, go support Evelyn's brother at her ice cream shop. And Courtney, you know, Courtney who sells feet pics. Well, apparently she is this high stakes real estate agent now, and she travels around on private jets. So she's loving the private jet flying around real estate agent life. If you happen to have a house that you want to sell or buy, hit her up. She'll be your real estate agent. But Courtney, let me tell you something. Someone that used to work in real estate many moons ago, real estate is a roller coaster. So girl, you might be back to trying to sell feet pics before you know it. So enjoy the private jets while you can. And I just wanted to let you guys know that every Saturday night at 9 Eastern, 6 p.m. West Coast time, my girl, Mommy Says Bad Words, Susu Studio, 90 Day Fancy Beast, and Cleo Bear all do this thing called Saturday Night Shenanigans. And it's like this game night. I just want to say it's basically game night. Sometimes it's 90 Day Fiance related, sometimes not. You guys need to pop in. One night they had Mike, Jimenez Mike, and Caleb on. So you never know who's going to pop by. You never know what's going to happen. It's always a lot of fun, a lot of laughs. It is on Mommy Says Bad Words 2 YouTube channel. I'm going to put the channel in my notes. You guys need to check it out every Saturday night, 9 Eastern, 8 p.m. Central, 7 p.m. Mountain, 6 p.m. East Coast time. I cannot do time zone math. My brain is way too scrambled. So you guys should check it out. It's a lot of fun. I'm in there sometimes. I try to go in there every Saturday night, but check it out, guys. So finally, as I close out my this week's edition, I was going to say my last edition, but it won't be my last edition. You can't get rid of me that easy, guys. This week's edition of 90 Day Oy Vey, I just wanted to say, like Yazan, enjoy every moment of life while you can. I woke up this morning, it was 93 degrees in New York. In the beginning of the week, I was freezing my ass off, and now it's summer. Enjoy every moment, because you never know what could come next. Thank you so much for your support. Please subscribe if you don't already. Don't forget to check out our 90 Day Say What on Monday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 p.m. West Coast time with Monty's advice. And if all this reality TV stuff gets you all riled up, check out Brianna's Nirvana. She has hypnosis, meditation, sleep stories, and all this other good stuff that'll help you relax. And that's basically it. Thank you so much. Have a good night, day, weekend, whenever you're watching me.